Welcome to our next video of Selenium C Sharp with SpecFlow series. In this video, we'll discuss how we can write a simple test with SpecFlow along with Selenium and run them in our local machine. We'll also learn a bit of SpecFlow jargons like given, when, and then, and writing hooks along with the step definition implementation and some usual Selenium driver steps, as well as hooking the Selenium driver within the context injection. So let's get started. So if you remember, this is the project that we created in our last video of this series by creating a simple SpecFlow project from the project template. And now we are going to actually write a scenario in this particular feature file. So the first thing which I'm going to do is we're going to change the project name. So we'll change the name to non-Chrome browsers, and I'm going to change the feature name as well. And let's get rid of these text. Testing non-Chrome browsers, and we're going to write a scenario over here. So the scenario is going to look something like this. As you can see within the scenario, we actually have a tag like to-do app, and I have written a scenario saying add items to the to-do app on the Firefox browser. So the scenario starts with given I navigate to the LambdaTest app on the following environment, like the browser, browser version, and operating system, and then I have told and I select the first item, and I select the second item, and I enter the new value in the text box. When I click the submit button, then I verify whether the item is added to the list or not. So this is the simple scenario that we are going to be implementing in this particular SpecFlow scenario. So the step definition name should also be ideally different. We're just going to rename this to browser step def, and we're going to rename the project reference element as well. And you can see within this particular browser step definition of the project template, it also created a structure of the step definitions file from the template itself. It actually has a context injection using the scenario context, and it also has the step definitions. But as you know that these step definitions are kind of obsolete at the moment because these are from the sample calculator application step definitions, we need to generate the step definitions for this particular scenario. In order to do that, I'm just going to right click. I'm going to select this generate step definitions. I'm going to copy this method, and then I'm going to just paste them all over here. And this marks the step definitions creation for us. And these are the usual SpecFlow things that we need to do. And once we have the step definitions being generated, the next thing we need to do is we need to create the hooks and the drivers. So within this driver, we are going to start writing the Selenium driver code. But before that, we also need to add the dependency for the Selenium so that we can start working with it. So we're going to select this manage NuGet package. We're going to go to the browse and search for Selenium, and we're going to add this Selenium web driver. And because we are working with the table structure of the SpecFlow, we also require the SpecFlow's assist package, which will help us to work with the table structures. So I'm going to install the SpecFlow Assist Dynamics as well. And once we have all the required references within our project, then we can start implementing the drivers. So I'm going to create a driver class, and this Selenium driver is going to be a public class, and it's going to have the scenario context for the Selenium driver as well, which is going to look something like this. This is the SpecFlow scenario context. So we're going to add the references as well as for the iWeb driver. And then we're going to create a constructor with the scenario context in it. So the initialization is done right now. And we can also use the expression bodied constructor to shorten our code. Next up, we need to create the web driver initialization for the browser that we're about to launch. It can be a Firefox browser or Chrome browser or any browser of that matter. So we need to create that method, and it's going to look something like this. So this is the setup method, which is going to be creating a hard-coded Firefox browser option for us, along with the remote web driver, which is going to create the initialization for us. And it's going to run within our local machine, and that's why we have actually created the path for the local host, which is going to be running our Selenium web driver over here. So the Firefox option, we need to be initializing, and we need to add the references for both Firefox option as well as the remote web driver option. And because we'll be working with the Firefox, we also need to add the NuGet package for the Firefox Geekode driver, which is going to be this one. All right. And now the Selenium driver class is almost ready. Please note that we are actually setting the scenario context with the web driver that we are creating over here. And this is the one that we'll be using within our hooks class to actually destroy the web driver or quit the web driver. So next up is going to be creating the hook initialization. So I'm going to create a class called as hook initialization. And this class is going to create or hold all the hooks. And there is a better way to work with SpecFlow to create the hook initialization, which we can do using its inbuilt template method of SpecFlows. So if you choose the new item, and if you go to the SpecFlow, you can actually choose the event binding SpecFlow hooks and then create the hook initialization. So this way, there will be a structure of the hook automatically created for the SpecFlow scenario. So within this before scenario attribute, we are going to create or call the Selenium driver class, and we're going to initialize the Selenium driver class here, and then we're going to be initializing the context injection which is required for us. And now within this scenario context, we are going to set the object of the Selenium driver as well, and we can search the Selenium driver using the key Selenium driver. And of course, we need to pass the scenario context over here so that it gets the instance of it. And once we have this, we also need to quit the driver, which we are going to do in the after scenario over here. So let's add the reference, and that's it. So now we have the Selenium driver and the hook initialization. The last option we need to do is to actually implement the browser's step definitions, which is going to hold our actual test that we are going to be performing. So for doing that, we again need to call our scenario context and the URL that we are going to be navigating in this particular step definition, which we can actually implement something like this. And as you can see, it requires a driver, and we're going to add the driver's reference over here. So now we have the Selenium driver, the object that we created in the hook, and then we are calling the setup method, and then we are navigating to the URL, which is nothing but the LambdaTest GitHub io.sample to do app. And these step definitions we can actually implement using the code which is available from the LambdaTest support document over here. And as you can see, we already have the SpecFlow, MSTest, and NUnit code sample. And you can see the step definitions being implemented here. So we're just going to copy paste the code right into our project, and we'll see how it actually works. So I'm just going to do that over here, and then I'm going to add the references for the assert, and that way the code is completely being implemented. So this ends our complete building of the scenario along with the Selenium driver as well as the hook initialization. So now if we try to build this solution, and if we start running this particular test, this code should work as expected. So let's try running this code. And now this code is actually going to run within our local Selenium driver. And as you can see, it is launching the browser and it's running the test, and the test has got successfully completed. In our next lecture, we'll see how we can run the same test in parallel execution in our local machine using SpecFlow and Selenium C#.
In case you have any questions or you require any further information, you can chat with the team, or you can also drop us an email at support@lambdatest.com. We're here to help, and we'd love to hear from you. Subscribe to our channel to stay on top of exciting features on your way. Happy testing!